Responsive design helps your project display perfectly on any screen sizes, like desktop, tablet or mobile. And an important thing you may need to pay attention to is managing objects. Let's keep on watching this video to know more about working with objects in the responsive project. Firstly, insert an object as normal. When you start creating a responsive project, the layout is Flexbox by default. So the inserted object will automatically be snapped to the layout when you move it on the canvas. See how to work with Flexbox video for information. To easily manage it, right-click, and select Exclude from Container Layout. You can drag the resizing handles to resize or reposition the object, or edit in the Transform section of the Size and Properties tab. For example, with the selected position mode, I can change the left and top value. The unit of object position value which I use here is percentages. However, you can change it to pixels. For the height value, the auto unit is selected by default. It means that when you change the width value, the height value will be changed too. I want to illustrate about social distancing, which is considered as an effective way to prevent the spread of coronavirus. So I will insert an arrow between two people. The text box section allows you to customize the position of the text inside its container, and the text scale. You can change the text scale value to increase or decrease the text size on bigger or smaller devices. Let's see these objects in the tablet landscape layout. You can see that the arrow's position is lower than that I set in the desktop layout. In order to keep the arrow at the middle, you can change to other layouts and adjust manually, or align vertically center all of them. The boundary of objects in a responsive project in the smaller layout will be inherited from the larger layout. For example, when I align vertically center the objects in the tablet landscape layout, they will automatically be aligned in the tablet portrait layout and smaller layout. Let's see the output. Thank you for watching.